First of all, we did a very big casting during almost 7 months with the casting director Gisela Krenn. And because we had in our minds very clear that we really needed exceptional girls to play the main roles, to be very authentic, to be very, well, very honest, no? And it was a tough work to find them. And once we had them, we didn't give them the script to read. So we didn't do any rehearsals. What we did instead of rehearsaling was to meet with them and with the coach, Ruben Martinez. And we were doing different sessions. For example, one day we would do a picnic in a park. Another day we would go to these jumping beds, no, of the, also in the park. And of course, the most important, many of this time before the shooting, we programmed some classes about how was the year 1992. So they would know which expressions they should use, which other expressions were totally out of, I mean, didn't even exist, no, at the beginning of the 90s in Spain. And also to explain them a little bit about Spanish recent history, no, that in the year 1992, it was the year of the Olympic Games, of the Expo de Sevilla, and all the story behind. Natalia, because she was my first choice. I love everything of Natalia. I love the way she looks, and I think she's an actress with a lot of authenticity, and that's what I was looking for. And I was super lucky because we sent her the script, and she was supporting it since the beginning. She said yes to us, and she told us, we were talking a lot about that because she was born in the 90s. And she was explaining to me that many things that happened in the script, they were very close to her in her routine when she was Celia's age. And also she was very close because of her older sisters, because they are more or less my age. And she was connecting to the story in many ways. And she was a gift for the project, Natalia. She supported it in many ways. And also during the shooting, she helped me in everything she could. Super long, because I actually, the first time I had the idea about the film, it was maybe 10 years ago that I found this notebook from school with a religion essay that actually appears in the film, and made me realize or made me see, you know, that in the year 1992, we were not as modern as I thought. And I just started to ask people surrounding me, like my siblings, my friends, and I started to remember how really was the year 1992 in Spain. And then, I took a lot from my own memories, and I always said I didn't make up anything, I didn't invent anything, because I take everything from, maybe it's not my experience, but they are the experiences of the people that are related to me, friends, or other people that I was interviewing during the documentation process. So it took us a very long time to do it. And actually, this is the type of film that we were even writing the script during the casting, because we were also adapting the script to the casting, yes. So the girls. I work with Daniela Cajías. She's a cinematographer. We didn't know each other before. The first time we met, she was in Mexico, so we were talking over Skype, but we connected very well because we have a very similar way to understand cinema. And we made like, our idea was to make a psychological approach to the film through the light and through the colors. And we made like well, in a notebook, the different stages of Thelia and how the light was going to be in every moment. And it was a very funny job to do with her. And actually, she was also proposing me to shoot in this aspect ratio. And I think it was a very good decision and a very good, it was something that I think gives a lot to the film, not only because of this nostalgic mood, also because I think it allowed us to be closer to Thelia and to her eyes and also of the mom. And well, she takes care a lot, Daniela, of the film, not only of her job, no, about the narrative and about the feeling and the emotions. And I think this is the most important.